All right, so I have a weird change of of room here. Yeah, I have a few things to talk about. I've been busy. I've been making this EU Castle Collective. Now, the EU Castle Collective is quite exciting. I've made a whole bunch of pages, and it runs through facet names. That's the grouping is your associated facet with your castles. So if you're the Falzon facet group, because you have this French name again and again and again, you're associated with any of the castles that start with FAU. So I've tried to make a whole bunch of interesting collection. It's a collection organization grouping for each one. So if you're a Vaux, it goes with the Vaux groups, all the Vaux castles, okay? The Vals, all of them. So I put all of those together. And so you can actually now, instead of just going to the website and looking at it and go, well, those are in Herault, and that's very difficult, or Herault, that's very difficult to even understand or know where the castles are under your name. So I tried to put them exactly in your name. And then I also included an organization place of the regions, and I as well. So it'll tell you not only the names, but if you want to know where. Then also, no, I have not stated whether they're ruins or not. That's quite a lot of taskmaster to do. But yeah, thank you to Wikipedia for all of this information, and the people who have given quite a bit of data out there. I know a lot of it's probably realtors, you know, sell, you know, we want to sell all these castles, but actually that's wrong. We don't want to sell the castles. The EU Castle Collective is not about selling the castles. It's about the people who were originally the owners of the castles through the centuries. All of our names, kings, queens, counts, comtesses, all of these incredibles to return to the roost. So if you have in your name, you know, like I have the de Berry, I found actually just yesterday a new one, William Wallace de Berry, which is very, very fun. So it's an extra one for the bear. So I have the BER castles, any of the bear castles. So it's, when I look at this lineup, it's almost like it was intentional, because it includes the valleys, it includes the mountains, it includes the birds, it includes very much the landmark. The landmark habits of the time, you know. And so it's kind of fun. It's a kind of a fun look back at history, that the castles were organized this way, with these particular namesakes of you know, the indigenous native lands. And when we look even into a name like Roche-Guyon, that's a fun one. That they say that's one of the oldest names in history, is the Roche-Guyons. And that's one of my fun names to have also. So when you have that, the rocks, you know, back to the rocks, and you have actually I don't know the I'm sorry, I don't have the one for Guillaume, but when you have all of that going on, it's just really incredible. It's an incredible way to look at it. You know, we create these little facet groups, but they'll be big. This is not a limit group. This is, you know, the more you know about your genealogy, the more facet groups you find. So it's not to be a limit. It's not to be a limit at all. But they have to be French names. You have to have a French name that is very, very similar or same to a castle that's in France to be included with the French facet groups. We have to have a rule somewhere. Okay. So you can't just say you have that name over there in England and you qualify. It has to actually be the name of the castle, similar or same. Okay, so when I'm also looking at further on, I went with regions also. I included a section for the regions of the castles, and that that's kind of fun because I with that there are baronies. So if I created the baronies, that means like with Vaucluse, there is that one group, the Vaux, that qualify for the Vaucluse section. And nobody else. So it'll just be for the Vaux. So unfortunately, what's happened between now and then, with the land, with the, you know, the proliferation of whatever is there, unfortunately, that's something that they sunk on the Vaux properties. And those castles, though, are very much your association. So we have that what I went with was a 50% voting for the barons and the baronesses who have a region. So if you're a Vaux and your region is Vaucluse, you have 50% voting rights. In you know how many of the, if there's 10 of you grouped together, that's 50% voting rights. And the other 50% goes to the original facet name of the castle. So let's say that the facet name of the castle is a Guéron. So the GER group, the GER group, actually have the other 50% voting rights of the castle. So it's a regional, and then it's the actual castle itself, that group that are the original castle name. So it's kind of fun. And in those votings will be the simple votings, like what you're going to do for the castle. Like, are you going to, how big is it going to be? You know, how big a build are you doing? Because a lot of these are ruins, just grubble to the ground, there's nothing. So how big, how ostentatious, you know, what are the plans? All of those will be votes for, in that instance, that would be the vote for the Gers and the Vaux to make that decision. All right. So that's kind of fun. So that's where I've been going. So if you want to go to the website and look at it, it's called the EU Castle Collective, and hopefully we'll get 1 million people. You know, that's the long-term plan, is to get 1 million people that are included. It also, along the lines of the future, is to have a long-term savings plan. And with each little share that you put towards the castle collective, each share that you purchase goes into a long-term retirement savings, similar to an IRA, but it won't be held here in the United States that I know of. I believe it'll be held over in probably Luxembourg or another EU country, even Switzerland. So that's where I'm trying to send the hype for it, because I want the workers. I want the workers who are us, you know, the original castle names there. I want you to go there and spend a summer, but that in the same time, or even longer, you know what I mean. At the same time, I also need you to keep investing in it, and by keeping investing, we become a hotel chain. Do you understand? As we become a hotel chain, then there you are. You know, more and more each year, what you put in is your investments. You know, making that original castle, building it from the ruin it was to something gracious. Then, or even a spectacle, they call them. You know, even going into making a wonderful exposition. It can be art shows, it can be museums, you can have all kinds of things. You can just have wonderful, concerts. Or you can have a 4th of July as type of events, you know, those types of events, Bastille Day hype, you know, all of that can go on. So which is funny, it's the opposite of the Capetians, but that we would go with a Bastille Day, but it is something they all celebrate also. But that would bring, you know, we're talking about money bringing into France, you know, major money bring. And so we raise the castles. That's how we do it. Now, you know, you can't just say anybody can raise the castle. So that's why I've come up with this collective. And so it's originators of France. It's the original French people. So we're going to have a lot less, what do we call it, racial discrimination against us for being Americans or British, treading on the turf of the French. As long as they know that we are original French, we are the original French, then they'll be excited for us. And obviously they're invited in, as an inclusion. They can also join and participate. So it's a whole bunch of different aspects to it. It's not just one. You know, it's, you can go in as a worker similar to a wolfer, or later on you could even buy a castle outright. So there are different types of degrees of how you'd like to do it. Now what I want to talk about was the ruins themselves. I don't want them purchased. I don't want them purchased by private owners. I feel that that's already going to be out of the hands of the Castle Collective. So I have to be tight on that. I have to say no. I say you have got to not allow that. All right. Anyway, I don't want to go on too long today, but yeah, and obviously those ridiculous other things that happen, such as timeshares, like maybe four of you really want in on one castle, and you don't want it to be, you know, set up as a hotel, you know, those types of things can materialize also. However, the whole process has got to be this, you know, back to the remakes themselves. When I say the remakes themselves, I'm really, really pushing RAM construction. The RAM construction is sustainable. It's one that is quick, and it's proven. Okay. I wrote a little blog today about it. So that's where we're at, and I hope I explained the collective enough. So if your name is Fontaine, and even if you're not a bloodline royal, like me, you know, wonderful, if you're not a bloodline royal, that's okay. If you're not even a bloodline of a Fontaine, but your last name is Fontaine, that is all right also. As long as it's been your name for several generations, you're a Fontaine. Do you understand? Yeah, no matter your color. So this is not a discrimination group. All right. So it's fun. So we're gonna build castles, and hopefully with that, people will understand it's not gonna be a big paying business during the castle building process. We're not gonna be paying out big sums of money, because our workers will be ourselves. And so it's really just going to be the grounds where we live, quite inexpensively, and it's going to be the food that we eat inexpensively. So it's not going to be a big tourist jaunt around France, unless you can afford it. It's going to be just, you know, you heading into France and working on a castle as long as you can, and then heading out. So that's going to be what it's all about. All right. And also forming with each group, I forgot that yet. Each group will have business opportunities also, networking business opportunities. So if you build drawbridges in one, and that's your business, that's your castle. If your castle decides you want to build drawbridges for the other castles, well then great. That's your business. And so that will be your network. We'll increase your network. So we'll become our own yellow pages. All right. All righty. Oh, and sheep and cheese and all of that, you know. And some of those things are mandatory on these estates. They're just mandatory. You have to make your own cheese, and you have to have your own pastoral animals. All right.